But I have a congressman with me who, as we like to say, is in the room for this stuff right now. It's Democratic Congressman Raja Krishnamoorthy. He's a member of the Oversight Committee and the Intel Committee, which is obviously the lead of the impeachment investigation. So we're getting among the first responses yet of anybody in Congress to this letter from the White House. Congressman, thank you. I know you've been sitting there listening to us a little bit, hearing the political discussion, but I want to get your first reaction to the letter from the White House to Speaker Pelosi and all of the chairmen of the three committees on this coming shift and angle, essentially saying this is not a constitutional investigation.
Well, as I think someone pointed out, there doesn't seem to be a legal argument for this letter. It seems to be a political letter, and I wouldn't be surprised if some parts of it are in all caps. But the point is that it appears that they're, again, trying to stonewall and delay. But I think that the difference in this inquiry compared to past investigations is that this type of behavior will constitute evidence of obstruction of the inquiry. And secondly, any blocked evidence or testimony will be viewed as an almost admission or corroboration of the whistleblower's complaint. The third point I want to say is just that I think that right now the White House might be getting something wrong, which is that I think the American people, public sentiment has changed significantly, and the American people want this inquiry to proceed, and they believe that something has seriously gone wrong. And so I think they want us to actually ferret out the facts and figure out exactly what's going on. And so if you're standing in the way of it, I think you're standing really opposite where the American people want to go right now.
I know that legally you guys have the powers you need. There's a reason why you didn't have to do the vote to open an impeachment inquiry as the previous ones, because you gave yourself that subpoena power with the House rules changes at the start of this Congress. That's the legal explanation of why you don't need to. But let me ask you this. Why not call their bluff? They think you guys are afraid of doing this vote. Why not put everybody on the record on this? There's part of me that thinks that what's wrong with the American public knowing where everybody stands on whether this deserves investigating or not?
I think a lot of us have already gone on record on this, but right? I think the second point is that, quite frankly, I don't think anybody wants to receive their orders from the White House as to how they should be investigated.
And Congressman, do you think how many of those House Republicans want to go on the record on this? I know a bunch, quite a few of them do. You think they all do?
I don't know, is a short answer. I would just point out one thing, which is right now, I think most people want to expeditiously conduct this inquiry because of one overriding issue, which is if the whistleblower complaints allegations are to be believed, there is an ongoing scheme today to basically exert pressure on the Ukrainian government's leaders, maybe even other governments, to basically meddle in our 2020 elections. And so we got to stop that right now.
You obviously know Gordon Sondland was blocked from testifying.
Yes.
Ambassador Ivanovich is supposed to testify Friday. What's the likelihood you're going to see her?
I don't know. Each time these depositions or hearings come up, sometimes we have to wait until the last minute to know whether they're going to show. But I think that in the case of Ambassador Ivanovich, my understanding is that she wants to testify. She wants to cooperate. And so the question is whether, you know, the Trump administration will be able to block her. In the case of Sondland,
Gordon Sondland said he wanted to testify. He flew here to do it. And they he claims that it's state that blocked him.
And so this is where I think Chairman Schiff and the other chairmen and women are going to have to make a decision, which is whether or not to issue a subpoena directly to Mr. Sondland for his records and documents and for his testimony. I should just point out one small thing, which is that Mr. Sondland actually turned over a tranche or a set of documents, including texts and emails, to the State Department. So they have these materials in their possession. And so perhaps a subpoena directed right at him will compel him to produce it to us, and maybe that's what he's waiting on. But I can't read his mind, but we'll be following our chair people and leadership as to the next steps. But we absolutely have to pose the choice to them, which is, do you go along with the Trump administration on this stonewalling and delaying, or do you kind of come forward, come clean, and produce your documents?
Why do you think, and I know I need to go, we need to let you go, but why do you think that strategy will work? I'll say it this way. The president doesn't think there was any penalty for obstruct. I mean, the Mueller report accuses him of obstructing justice multiple times. Hasn't bothered him, hasn't bothered his supporters, hasn't bothered congressional Republicans. Why do you think obstructing is going to bother them now?
I think that the public sentiment has shifted so much that at this point, I think people believe that there's a presumption that something is very wrong. They saw the July 25th call transcript. They saw the whistleblower complaint. They saw the Trump-appointed inspector general come forward and call the complaint credible and urgent. And that's very significant. This is a gentleman, by the way, Mr. Atkinson, who had no incentive to come forward on his own to produce that complaint, and he did at risk of his career. And so I think those facts really kind of compel people to think, well, okay, if they're stonewalling or delaying, they're trying to protect themselves against disclosure. So why are they doing that? It must be because they're trying to hide something. And I think that is a big presumption that the Trump folks have to overcome, which I don't think they can in this case.
Well, especially the fact that the whistleblower, there's fears for their safety.
That's right.
Anyway,
that's exactly
Congressman,
right. Yes.
Raja Krishnamoorthy is always...